Good morning, YouTube. Alright, it's another fish tank video, so if you're a car person, go away. Don't click downvote, just go away. Or if for some reason you're really bored, feel free to watch it, but then don't downvote, just don't vote.
You right. know, if you say don't downvote, they're all just gonna downvote.
No, like, they didn't downvote my stuff last time.
Okay.
Anyway, alright, so we're in crisis mode, or at least we're in, we've tempered the crisis, so. Let me show you what happened and explain what's going on with the fish tank, but let me tell you, this is not the greatest way to wake up in the morning. Alright, so if you didn't know, this fish tank is actually controlled by those computers right there. It's called Apex. Basically, it's it connects to the internet, allows you to control stuff, monitor stuff, and set alarms and all sorts of cool things. So the Apex has this power strip right there that it controls, and you can see I got them labeled. Those are the different plugs that turn on and off pumps or lights or whatever for the tank. So at about 7 something this morning, what I believe happened is that the power strip right there that's controlled by the Apex fried itself. The reason I think so is if you look here on this picture, you can see that the amps on it spiked way up to like 30 amps, so something in that thing shorted out. It's possible that one of the devices shorted out, but I haven't been able to test them all yet. So far, so good, because the biggest concern would be the lights, but the lights weren't on at that time of the day. So, and the main pump is already running again. So, anyway, so the Apex power thing fried itself. And then what happened is the main pump shut off, so the water level in the tank dropped, right, because all the water stopped pumping, and came into the sump. So the water level in the sump was about here, which caused the protein skimmer to overflow. So the protein skimmer was running too fast, it overflowed, and the water was dripping off the back of the protein skimmer onto the outside of the sump, which then pooled the water behind the sump, and it came over here and triggered this leak detector. And so probably, I'm gonna guess maybe 15 minutes after the power went out, my leak detector started going off, which caused the Apex to trigger an alarm. So the alarm woke me up, came out here, found a tank that was only half running, because we have two of those power strips. The other one was fine, it's still working correctly. So we had a fart around with it, plug stuff in, unplug stuff, figure out why is it not working, and we determined that that power strip is dead. So luckily, my friend Brian has one of those power strips, and we're going to go buy it from him. So thank you so much, Brian. I'll be seeing you in about a half hour, well, a little bit longer than that because I got to take a shower. But that is why you have to have friends in the reef keeping community if you have a tank. You have to join your local clubs. You have to become an active member, because within 15 minutes of us determining we needed to replace that power strip, we sent out some Facebook messages, texted a couple friends, posted on some message boards, and we found someone in town that has one immediately. So it's really important to be a part of your local community when you're reef keeping, because people will help you out. And it's crazy. Brian even was like, oh, you know, I'll sell it to you for super cheap. I'm like, dude, don't sell it for me cheap, like, sell it to me for what you think is right. So, anyway, Brian, thank you again. We'll be seeing you shortly. So, I'm going to go down there, pick up this EB-8. It's called an EB-8. I'm going to go pick up the EB-8 from Brian, replace it here, and yeah. So, let me show you how we're keeping the tank alive at the moment. So, I went out to the garage, grabbed an extension cord, ran it over here, and just have a regular old power strip. And right now, all I did was plug in the main pump and the secondary pumps. I left off all the other stuff. So the tank won't have any light for this morning until I get this thing running, but that's okay. It doesn't need it. And I had to make sure to shut off the calcium reactor, because the calcium reactor runs the CO2 relay is run by that power strip, and it's controlled on and off according to the pH. So right now it would just be constantly dumping in CO2, and it would probably kill the tank, so that would not be very good. All right, I'm gonna head on down to Brian's and get a new power strip. Okay, just got back from picking up the EB-8 from Brian.
Got pulled over for no front license plate. Cop was very nice, but that was annoying. He was like, do you know that you need to have a front license plate on this car at the furthermost point of the car? I'm like, yes, I do, sir. And he's like, does this car have the ability to do that? I'm like, not without drilling the car, sir. And he's like, I understand. I know these high-end cars, people don't usually put them on. I'm like, yeah. And I was ready to get the ticket, and then he said, all right, well, I'm going to give you a warning so long as everything clears out. He did ask me, have you ever been pulled over for this before? I said, no, which I haven't. I wasn't lying. And he's like, okay, well, so long as you haven't been pulled over for it before, I'm going to give you a warning. I'm like, okay. So I suspect now the next time I get pulled over, I won't get a warning. Damn. But anyway, here's the EB8, the power thing. So this is going to be a little bit of a pain in the ass because I have to unwire the old one, pull it out, unscrew it off the back of the stand, get all the wiring shit out of there, reprogram that one. Yeah, you actually got to program it, so. All right, let's get to it.
So I've unscrewed the old one. I still have it plugged in at the moment to the actual system so I can keep the system powered up. So I'm going to try and plug the new one in and then screw it in. Actually, maybe I'll screw it in first. That'll be easier. All right, new unit is plugged in, and so now I need to transfer the connection wires off the old one, then reprogram the system to work with the plugs. Okay, so I just finished reprogramming all the configurations so that it's programmed with the new outlets, and they got everything plugged in. So everything seems to be on and working correctly. Now I just need to make that rat's nest look a little better and get it all tucked away. Okay, I got the rat's nest tucked away. Everything's powered on and running correctly, so all the fish are happy, the corals are happy.
All right, crisis has been resolved. That was a pain in the butt. So it turned out, yeah, the old power brick is screwed up. I'm probably gonna take it apart, see if I can see if there's any electronic damage in it or whatever. I doubt it. I I'm pretty certain it's not under warranty because it's over 3 years old. So maybe I can send it off and get it repaired for cheap or something like that and then have a backup. I'll probably do that just to be safe. But all right, well, there you go. Fish tank crises. Pain in the ass. You guys are amazing. Thank you for watching, especially if you're a car person. Thank you for not giving me the thumbs down and giving me the thumbs up, maybe, but appreciating that sometimes I do non-car stuff, even though it's a car channel. But we'll see you guys soon. We'll be doing more car stuff then. But in the meantime, consider subscribing, maybe watch that video. And it's a long stretch here, but give me a thumbs up. All right, we'll see you then.